the story so far. After carrying out her duties in Goldshore, all that remained for Ophelia was to bring her ember back to Flame's Grace. But before she could do so, Lyanna appeared before her. Ophelia's sister had come to tell her of their father's passing. Yet, when Ophelia attempted to confront her desperate sister, she was betrayed, and her sacred ember was stolen from her. Can you truly bring my father back? You really mean it? As she slipped from consciousness, Ophelia heard those words. Who was Lyanna speaking to? Who had stolen Lyanna's heart with such lies? Ophelia arrives in Whispermill to find out and bring this tragedy to a stop before she loses what little family she has left.
Hi, Ophelia!
Excuse me, might I ask?
Cleric of the Sacred Flame? I'm rather in a hurry, I'm afraid. Yeah, everyone is following a different religion, which is completely against the Sacred Flame, so everyone here will most likely treat her like a leper.
I see.
If I might have a moment.
I've got fields to till another time, perhaps.
Why?
You're from the church, eh? The Sacred Flame?
Yes.
Yes, I am. I am Sister Ophelia, if I might trouble you with just one thing. Is there perchance someone in this village known as the Savior?
Beats me.
What?
Seriously?
This is a peaceful farming village. We've got no troubles here. At least none we need your help with. So, if you're thinking of praying for us, you can go somewhere else.
Right.
I see. Sorry to bother you. A sister could get the impression she's not welcome around here. Best keep digging.
Okay, did that dude hear us mumbling to ourselves, or?
Wonderful.
I've seen friendlier faces in prison. I bet half of my ill-gotten fortune that Savior is here somewhere.
I agree. They are far too wary of us, for it to be anything else.
Looks like he's turned them all into true believers. No doubt by using some underhanded means. I wouldn't put manipulation past him.
Manipulation?
Tough times wear anyone down. Sometimes it leaves you weak and vulnerable. Those people want to be saved. They'll even start believing in miracles if it makes life easier for them. So, if you want to be a savior, it's just a matter of finding what those people need saving from, then tell them you can do it. Take it from me, most people have faith. More faith than they know what to do with.
But don't you think there are times when people truly need a savior? I believe it's not wrong to reach out for salvation when a helping hand is offered.
Then I suppose we'd best make sure it's us who do the saving.
Exactly.
Hey, what's over here? Oh, no.
Sister, please, are you from the church? You must help me. Whatever is the matter? My child, my boy, he suddenly took ill.
This is trap.
Please, you must save him.
This is trap.
Goodness.
I understand. I'll do everything in my power to help him. Pray, take me to him. Sorry, we don't pray here.
Thank you so much.
Oh, thank heaven. He's just right this way, down this dark alley.
We've been in town for a few minutes. This is a shitty old shack.
Where's the child? I was promised children.
That's right.
I've brought the cleric, brother.
I am most grateful.
You have served us well. The Savior will be pleased. Oh, boy, that's a lot of men.
What?
Come again?
Oh, we will.
No.
Sister Ophelia, it is not wise to put too much trust in others. For there are many in this world who are all too eager to deceive.
It was a trap!
The fact of the matter is...
The Savior foretold your coming. He said a female cleric would come seeking the Ember. He said she was in truth a witch with the power to ensorcel the hearts of others, and that we should capture her before she brings ruin to our village.
That cannot be.
A witch? No. Hold on a moment. Give me a second. Give me a chance to explain. Ow. Oh, jeez. Oh, in a jail cell again. I know. I have a problem with my drink, and I didn't want to call everyone a cunt, but damn did I. Oh, so wait. Why am I here?
Awake at last, Sister Ophelia.
Wait, you're...
But...
Master Matthias, but you couldn't be...
I knew it.
Ah.
Oh, but I am. I suppose there's no need to hide the truth from you any longer. I am the one these people call the Savior.
You? Then the one who made Lyanna steal the Ember?
Yes.
Yes, that was me as well.
What?
But why? Why would you of all people do such a thing?
If I might.
Long ago, the gods brought fire from the heavens down to the earth to steal away one of their own. That is the sacred flame now worshipped throughout the land. Given your position in the church, I'm sure you're very well versed in the history of our world. But ask yourself this. What would happen if the sacred flame were to lose its power, if it grew weak and faltered?
This cannot be.
You can't be serious. You can't seriously mean to release the fallen god from his bonds.
Oh, perish the thought. I am not so foolish as that. And yet, even sealed away as he is, Gardera is possessed of great power. Gardera possesses great power would be probably a more appropriate way of writing that, but sure, fuck, why not? Power that he deigned to share with me. As his power grows, so does my own.
You must stop.
That power is forbidden. There is a reason the 12 gods sealed Gardera away for all eternity. It's not meant for the hands of men. Not even women. Some children, but depends on if they're girls or boys. It gets flaky about that, but...
That is not for you to decide. If the power exists to be taken, then exists to be used.
You're wrong.
You're abominable. Like a snowman.
Are we not the same, sister? Just look at these poor villagers. When disease was running rampant, they were desperate. All I had to do was save a few of them. Not many, but just a few. And they were all too eager to declare me their savior.
You save them?
Yes, with common medicine and knowledge.
Yes.
Nothing too fancy. As a loyal servant of Gardera, I wield a fragment of his great power. And yet, even that is but a fragment of a fragment sealed away, as he is. My master's powers are not what they once were. But Sister Lyanna's aid. With Sister Lyanna's aid, I will loosen those bonds.
Lyanna's here?
Of course. She's my loyal Vestal.
What?
Vestal?
Ah, but I must be going. There is much I still must prepare.
Fear not, Sister Ophelia. As long as you do not oppose me, I will do you no harm. After all, I might need a replacement for Liana, should August go amiss.
Holy fuck, dude, just speak real words. Oh my god. It's like trying to read Yoda's fucking script, and it's like, for not, you do, but me, fuck off. What?
What? Wait, we're not through here. Hey, you son of a bitch. Oh, I can't even spit on him. I'll kill you.
Oh. I've heard you, Therian.
We have to hurry and help Liana.
Let me speak.
Stay in now, child. We can do but little for now. Yes, but to panic is to make mistake. Thou shalt only make the situation worse. If you say so.
It's easier to read Hannet than it is to read that dickhead talking. Fucking, can we have Matthias jump off a bridge? Or at least learn how to speak English properly? Or, whatever. His own dialect and his voice actor probably do a very good job. It's just annoying, that's all.
First things first, thou needest rest, both for thy body and thy mind. 'Tis the same as a hunt. A hunter must be tranquil and alert. Else the quarry will turn the tables, and the hunter becometh the hunted. You use tables to hunt? You missed the analogy, you simple girl. We wouldn't want that now, would we? So listen, thou must be patient. Our time shall come, and when it doth, we shall strike in together. I'm most grateful to have you on my side, Hannet. Now, I shall heed my own counsel and sleep. Wake me if thou needest me. All right. Gracious, she fell asleep just like that.
For a second there, I thought,
gracias.
This is like, why the Spanish? Out of nowhere. Nope, that is not what she, was doing. How should I proceed? I want to look around a little bit. There might be something in... No. It's just a tiny cell. I want to look around a bit more. Let's wait and see what happens then. Why?
Ophelia? That voice.
Liana!
Shh. Not so loud.
I'm sorry, I'm very loud.
I'm sorry, Ophelia. I'll get you out of here.
I'm kind of getting used to it. I'm getting hard. I'm going to get a tattoo.
Liana, why?
A little teardrop for everyone I murdered. I murdered a lot of people.
I'm sorry, Feely. I did it for my father. He's gone. He left us forever.
Archbishop.
But the Savior promised me he can bring Father back.
Archbishop.
All I need to do is act as his vestal. Listen to yourself, Liana. This is madness you speak.
Are you cooking? Why do you need a pestle? Vestal. I don't know what that is.
What? How could you say such a thing?
I'm in prison. I'm hard now.
Do you not even care that Father is gone?
Archbishop.
Liana.
Wow, that's a harsh.
All those days we spent together. You and me and Father.
Archbishop.
Dining together, talking together, laughing together.
Of course I miss him, but I've also been on a mission. Shit, I stole the sacred flame. Your duty to go do it so you can spend more time with him in his dying hours. Fuck, could you imagine being on the road and me showing up and be like, ah, bitch, he's dead now. Boom, give me that. Fuck.
We'll never know that happiness again. Don't you even care? I do care, but that doesn't mean you can bring back the departed.
Or fuck with old gods. Those guys are dickheads.
I can't believe you, Ophelia. Were you always this cruel-hearted?
Prison made me hard.
Listen to me, Liana. Of course I wish His Excellency were still alive. But those who pass through the gate to the afterworld are never to return.
Well, it's typically a one-way ticket. People don't pay enough to get a two-way, you know, return ticket. Fuck, it's so much more expensive.
And if you let that man use this forbidden power, There's no telling what horrors might be unleashed.
Yeah, I was going to say roughly that, but I felt that the story is kind of leading up to it.
Father is coming back. I'll see to that.
I don't care how many children I have to bash against the rocks to do it. I want my father back.
You mean Archbishop? Mm-mm.
When he's back, we can all be a family again, just like before. Wouldn't you like that too, Feely?
Not if it brings back a dark god. Or if he's reanimated as, like, a half-zombie kind of thing. It'd make dinner difficult because of the smell of rotting flesh and the maggots that would fall off of him. But I'm sure he would... If he... You never really retain any memory of what occurs after, where your soul goes, or you can't really describe it, perhaps, because of how transcendental it is? It's beyond human comprehension, perhaps. It's not just simple, oh, I'm outside the gates and St. Peter tells me I'm a cunt. Tells me to take the escalator down. I'm like, really?
I'll leave the door unlocked. Please, get away from this place before anyone finds you.
Yeah, fuck off and leave. You heartless bitch.
And just leave the rest to me, okay?
Yeah, I'll bring back our dead daddy, and hopefully the old god doesn't come through in the process. Yeah, I have a plan.
Liana!
Do you have a plan? I don't think you have a plan.
Mati-kun!
Sorry, I've been watching an anime series recently, and there's a character that I just hate every time she says the protagonist's first name, because she just says it the exact same way every time.
Mati-kun.
Last episode, I think she said it like 6 times. I'm like, oh fuck, please just stop. I remember when I first started streaming this, I was doing Ophelia's mission. Someone is like, oh, there's a drinking game associated with Ophelia. Every time she says, Your Excellency, you drink. It's like, oh, what the fuck, okay. And they were really hung up on that. Every time, they just, Your Excellency, Your Excellency. The way that Ophelia says it is nowhere near as annoying as... I can't remember the name of the character in the anime. It's just,
Mati-kun.
it rings in a person's ears, I suppose, at a point.
Miss Liana has accepted the guidance of the Savior. She's consented to serve as his vestal. His pestle.
Good.
At last, finally all of our wishes will come true.
The Savior, Matthias, has won these people over. They believe his every word. What are they talking about, though? Wishes?
Oh.
Still, was it right that we did what we did to that poor girl? Attacking a cleric of the church and the flame bearer at that, it just doesn't seem right.
Bah! When did believing in the flame ever save anyone? Only the Savior deserves our faith.
Just so.
Damn right. The Savior's the only one who freed us from the plague. Mm-hmm. If we just do what he says, we'll find our salvation.
Hi.
Here, here.
Oh.
I suppose you're right.
Come on. The Savior told us to come to the cave outside of town. We shouldn't keep him waiting.
Good job, Ophelia. Just looking in the other direction.
Oh, shit, they're coming. I'm pretending you're making out with someone. A cave? That must be where Liana and Matthias went.
Ooh, travel banter.
Now then.
So, it's into the cave we go. I wonder what's inside. Maybe it's a cave of mysteries.
Now's not the time for archaeology, Professor.
Yes, quite right. Our priority is to rescue Liana. However, the cave may give us an answer to one of the questions that face us.
What question is that?
Did Matthias choose this particular village?
Could it be that the ceremony is to be held in that cave?
Precisely what I was thinking. If that is the case, then the cave is extremely important to Matthias's plans. But fear not. I shall do everything in my power to help rescue your friend.
Then surely we can't fail. Because you're OP as fuck right now, Professor.
He is very strong. And we rotate. Nothing huge has happened. Yeah. For anyone who was screaming before, oh, you have to save after that quicksand fight with the snake. Yeah, that was 77 hours in. Yeah, that was over 5 hours ago. Five and a half. So shut your fucking mouth, idiot. Not saying that, you know, I've looked at the YouTube comments 8 months from now when this goes up. But there is always some dumb fuck in the comments. Ugh. It's trying to backseat an individual. And it's like, had that with my Hyperdimension Neptunia Rebirth 2 Sister Generation playthrough. It's playing and someone in the YouTube comments is leaving little messages on most of the episodes. And they're like, oh, it seems like you're not taking my advice. I'm like, if you look at the timestamp, this file is from 8 months ago. Are you trying to backseat me from the fucking future? Like, what are you talking about? And that person never said a goddamn thing ever again. Because they realized they were fucking stupid and they needed to go away.
An interesting dilemma. A great inferno to scorch the land.
A disco inferno, perhaps. You know, dealing with this mix-up, next time I'm going to do a big sweep with Hannet. And then, beat the shit out of everyone with double fireball should wipe them all out appropriately. Again, these bats are disgustingly weak.
I'll not be defeated.
My party has been taking a ton of damage. I don't know when this happened. Alright, these fuckers should be dead.
My turn.
After this. This might do it, honestly. And then the second one? Yeah.
Don't start things you can't finish.
Fuck all for XP, though, in this little cave. Massive difference from the previous area where I was getting a shit ton of experience. But these bastards... Ooh, I might have to change up my equipment entirely for things that protect from... that give me a lot of elemental defense. Yeah. Plus 162 elemental defense. Yeah, I might have to take a look through that and see... Because... can't really judge it from the first encounter. Fighting a monster, being like, ah, everything's gonna hit 10 times as hard with elemental magic and shit. Really? Oh, okay.
Can't we settle this?
Yeah, magic? Everyone's gonna be hanging with heavy magical attacks. Look at these magic girls.
Now,
yeah, definitely in the spot for something
great
like that.
Inferno
Disco
land.
Inferno did nothing for you, hey?
What?
Is it lightning then?
Shut.
I'm happy to see that you're all weak to dagger. It's not? Is it lumescence? You don't hit where the fuck physically, which is not too shocking. Not weak to arrows either. Shit. This is a whole different batch of chicks I've never seen before, so I don't know what hurts them yet. Had a feeling light magic would do it. So, how y'all feel about getting an axe to the face? Most people are incredibly allergic to that. Okay, not a physical, only that.
Out of my way.
My two magic wielders, other than their dagger attacks, are left woefully ill-equipped for this. Gonna break you along the way. I feel like it's gonna get another chance to lay in a decent lumescence here. And I forgot that she has Dancer on her, so she can hit for dark and improve Hannet's physical abilities too, which is super useful. I didn't try I know that they're not weak to Blizzard, but Blizzard still hurts a fuck up a lot. Actually, of all the things I should have done with Cyrus, that was the worst one. Not necessarily the worst one. But it was... Did I just amputate? Okay, well, this works out. I can get his SP back. Is is what I wanted to do, but he's not going to get much back because it's a killing blow. Yeah. 49 is underwhelming as shit. Close to 500 XP. Woulda, coulda, shoulda, kinda be better. So you'll lead me up to that brown chest. How now, brown cow?
Come on, I've got better things to do. Alright.
So do this appropriately. Except you change up on me. You bastard.
May the sacred flame shine forth.
Soften them up. And we soften them a tiny bit more. They get a couple of good turns to lay in a couple of smucks. Your schmuck and muck. They're not hitting hard.
Letting the hunt
begin. For some reason, it feels like they're doing a decent amount of damage. Lindy, why? That one's not even weak to spear. Well, it's gonna be another four turns of that bullshit. Unless I try to just murder them all right now. Yeah.
Not bad.
I don't understand you, Lindy. Why spear, not swipe with a sword? Why an enemy that's not even weak to the goddamn attack? I don't get you, weird tiger. You're beautiful and majestic and shit, but holy fuck, could you please, maybe, can I just choose what attack you use? Is that asking too much? Sword.
Out of my way.
Okay. Well, that changes things a bit. Yeah. But
letting my arrow fly in true.
Nah.
A touch of death.
Now see, in the previous environment, I had the perfect party composition for the enemy's weaknesses. This environment, that is not the case. Can still do some incredibly heavy damage, but can do significantly more damage when everybody's broken. Okay, so Axe or Lumescence can do it. It just takes a hell of a lot longer for what I would consider a simple fight. She's going to get another chance on this, but actually, no. Ophelia is the only one that really needs the healing out of this. But I think... No. Zealot 2... They're all Zealot 2s. 128. There we go. That's what I want to see, baby!
Now, what next?
And then... We're going to fuck around just a tiny bit. We're going to give it to you.
Because
he has so much more SP that it fills up Hannah entirely.
My turn.
And then we're going to share with you to fill you up as well. Yes!
My turn now.
And now that you have carte blanche to just try to wipe them out? Oh no, you did not. But it's okay. Good old Hannet knows how to smack people in the face with an axe.
Sucks. The hunt endeth.
Really sucks to be allergic to an axe. I'd hate to experience it myself personally, but that worked out good. Patched up the party decent. The Ebony Grotto. Ooh, I like the name of that. It's kind of sexy. In a way, it is. Wait, does this lead just to a different section of the Ebony Grotto? It appears that is the case. Man, these areas have quite a few chests to them, don't they? There is loot. Sure, it's nothing special.